Whisper Gaming ASMR. I believe this is episode 6 of me playing the Diablo 4 open beta. And I said we'd do this in the last episode. We somehow did not get to it, but we'll be progressing the main storyline in this episode, so I'm gonna go do that right now. I have a feeling this might be starting with like a cutscene or some long dialogue, so let's just get through that. I guess we're going to the mining camp north of here. Just poured some tea. Let's see if I can drink it or if I'm gonna burn my mouth. Because her husband's cheating on her with some woman, which I think is going to be like a succubus or something, if I had to guess. Aim is also a little bit loud, I need to turn that down. Also, still not 100% sure how I feel about this game. It doesn't seem bad, and I'm trying not to let other people's opinions influence me too much, but I'm definitely susceptible to outside opinions a little bit, and just from the general feedback I've seen on YouTube, I haven't watched many videos, but just from like headlines, it seems like a lot of people are not liking Diablo 4 that much so far. Or they're at least saying it's unbalanced. Like, there's obviously a clear disadvantage to melee characters, especially the barbarian. Because I haven't played the barbarian, but I just saw a thing that apparently when you're out of combat, your rage goes down. So you always basically start fights with no resource and then have to build it up, and a lot of the bosses in this game have like slow effects or poison around them, which punish having to be like within melee range quite a bit, and then they just run around so you can't even really catch them because you're typically slowed or something. But I don't know, my character's pretty melee focused. At least I have these companions and have access to some ranged spells. But we'll see if I end up buying it when it first comes out. Still three months away, so a lot can happen, can change in that time. Well, I guess I'll give thanks to the shrine because we're kind of close to it. Then we'll run up to that forest and help this woman find her husband, who I have a feeling is going to be like dead or possessed or something. I'd be very surprised if it's a happy ending. God, there are a lot of ghouls out here. Nice, a crappy chest. And as you can see, I'm playing that. this mid-morning, we will see if the world slash city cooperates with me, or if there's a bunch of loud interruptions as usual. So far, so good. Gently knock on wood. I wonder where that superstition came from. Most of the inscription has been lost to time. A few barely legible words read gratitude, rewards, virtuous. What is the point of these shrines? It's like the second one I found, or maybe that's the one I found earlier. It says gratitude, I got ya. Okay. Gold rains upon you after your next kill. Okay, well let's go kill something then. That quest marker is off by quite a bit. Wasn't that much gold that rained down upon me. Okay, I did give thanks at the shrine. Do I have to do it again, or is this quest glitched? This is also a shrine. Oh, shit. I would not call that a shrine. But okay. My stomach keeps rumbling. I can't tell if the microphone's picking that up or not. Let's go find Christiana's husband. God, I'm rolling in the pipe, Barry. I guess we'll let myself get distracted yet again. I will say this game is good at dangling distractions in front of your face. So, has that going for it. How did I clear that cellar when the main bad guy is still alive? No chest. What a ripoff. Let's see, does that... Oh, that is actually... back in the, not original, in Diablo 2. I think I used a maul, but it does not seem like they still have that weapon type unless that falls under the category of mace. But the reason I thought of that is my girlfriend and I watched a movie last night. It's like relatively new with Anna Kendrick called Alice Darling. That movie, they several times make a reference to the difference between a maul and an axe. Also, wasn't a huge fan of the movie. It was okay. I like understood what they were going for, but I think it was mismarketed, at least like from the description and the trailer and stuff. It made it seem like it's gonna be a lot more of like a psychological thriller with kind of like a murder mystery mixed in with a missing girl, but it was basically just about a girl's trip with some friends dealing with her friend going through an abusive relationship, which, if it was marketed that way, I think it, I guess, brought you through that journey pretty effectively, but I don't know, it's a weird movie. I don't think I would strongly recommend it. The mall thing made me think of that because they referenced the difference between a mall and an axe 3 times in that movie, which was a bit of a odd choice for like a running gag, but... Okay, let's see. Where's this bitch's husband? I don't know. I guess it's just a world event. Being a merchant in this world seems terrible. All these caravans get fucked up. This would be a terrible world to live in. That animation was kind of cool. shit. Oh, oh god. Sorry, survivors. Oh my god, I'm not keeping any of these guys alive. Let's find this woman's husband so we can get rid of her. Yeah, hope that's not her husband. Something bad definitely happened there. Stairs, but apparently not. Oh shit. God damn. That's more fucked up than I was expecting. This guy has some pretty intense kinks. Not to kink shame, but Jesus Christ. God damn, I like can't stop looking away. It's like a train wreck. That's really, well, okay. Well, I guess it did surprise me with how dark that was. I was not expecting him to be completely skinless with his organs and shit hanging out. That's fucked. Oh, let's murder this woman. Let me guess, she's a banshee. Succubus or something. Oh shit. Oh god. Oh, she's kind of a weak bitch. Switch it out for those. I like my legendary boots because they have an orange color to the item icon, and for some reason that's pleasant. That woman was a demon. I've dealt with her. Is he still alive? Jesus, this guy won't. Dagger for guy. It's what you get for being seduced by a demon. Happens to the best of us. See how many, I really want to hit level 20, but I don't know how many videos I'm going to record today. It's like the last day I have to myself before I go back to my hometown. And I want to work on a lot of music today since I haven't had much time the past few days with... Well, actually, the past week I haven't had a ton of time because of everything going on with having people visit my girlfriend's messed up work schedule. Does anyone else ever get like weird resistance to doing things that you like want to do? Like I did play some music this morning, but I was kind of just like noodling around and not working on what I need to work on, and I watched a bunch of videos on music last night and stuff like that, and I was like, whenever I'm not playing, I wish I was playing, and then when I actually have the opportunity, loud car in the background. And then when I actually do have the opportunity to play, I like procrastinate by doing other stuff. And I have no idea. No idea why I do that, but am I the only one, or is that relatable? And I don't know. I also feel like I'm a little hard on myself. I feel like I do practice quite a bit. And I'm pretty motivated, but I always worry that I'm being too lazy. I feel like I'm not making progress as quick as I would like, but I think everyone feels that way to a certain extent. It's just hard with music. There's so much to learn, and it takes so much practice, and it's just hard to know what to prioritize, and if you're doing the right things. I don't know. Just rambling. It's my way of dealing with the guilt of playing a video game right now when I feel like I should be practicing music. Frame rate. Wow, this frame rate is so bad. Must be Lilith. Those friggin' bells on the side, like, why is her pack so jangly? Like, is she literally trying to be as loud as possible? Is this girl gonna be my first companion in the game? Guys, a pretty sick shield. I'll give those keys for this shitty fucking chest. Did that use one of my? Yep. Goddamn, that piece of that chest sucked. That was not worth. She's just gonna keep her mother's charm. Wow, I can't talk today. Keep that girl's mother's charm. That's kind of a dick move. You think you'd just give it back to her? Keep accidentally using health potions because I still apparently don't know the keys. How the heck did I just bring that thing up? I have this. Okay, well, it's cool. How the hell did I just bring that up? W, claim rewards. Okay. Oh, nice. Oh, okay, that's how I get the potion charge. Got ya. Strongholds. When do those pop up? No, I guess it's good that I came across that stuff. Even okay, that doesn't even reconnect to where I need to go. Let's go back to the actual quest. I wonder what the point of adding like this climbing and jumping across stuff is. It just to like give a sense of verticality, or does it have to do with the game loading new areas or something? Expanse knocking enemies back. Okay. I wonder what item gives me plus one to that ability. Thank you. leveled that up, or if I always had that and I just didn't notice it because I'm oblivious. I don't know if that'd be oblivious or illiterate, or both. Okay. So if I'm following this story right, Lilith is supposed to be in this mine somewhere. And this girl's mother decided to follow her down here for some reason. Assuming your mother has to be quite the badass then. For some reason I'm tempted to go back this way. No chest or anything. Wish you could get a bear companion in this game, I'm pretty sure. In Diablo 2, one of the followers was a bear. Shit, Sherlock. The lack of chests with legendary weapons in them is quite disappointing. Look at that. Chest full of nothing. Let's see. Oh god, I hope that's not her mom. This guy is concerned about the lift, and there's just like a bunch of completely desecrated corpses right there. Thank you. check to see if that's the body of anyone they know. Jesus Christ. Oh. Oh, it's not like a shower, like jumping. This girl's just like fighting with her bare hands. Possessed by Lilith. I was hoping that owl would heal my wolf, but it did not. Seems like there's no way to heal it, it just has to die and respawn. Okay, let's not pick up anything that's common anymore. Mine has fallen apart. I picked up a something circlet. Plus one rank. Divine creeper. Why not? Highland trousers. While injured. some shoddy reinforcements in this mine. This thing is falling apart. She say dead end again. Still does not seem very clear what our plan to get out of here is. If this mine is collapsing behind us. My inventory is filling up quite fast. Getting down there. Oh, I guess this way, down this giant-ass ladder. This hoist he's been obsessed with this entire time. Yeah. Well, there's your issue right there, slain demon in the gears. I should learn that one. But then I have to get rid of my cyclone armor. So many tough choices. I wish there was a summon one. Why is there no? Passive damage. that seems to work out well since I poison like everything I touch. The lift is right there. Why don't we just get reinforcements? That was convenient timing. I'm sure this isn't a trap. God damn it. I don't want to pick up those pants. Say, that guy doesn't seem dead. They're all dead except for that one guy that's clearly alive. Who did this?
Lilith.
That's my guess. Spells, prayers, all useless. Raise the army, the father. Evil itself walks sanctuary. This girl just loves stating the obvious. Why would this guy? Why would? She bribed her. I'm like, why would you give up your trinket that brings good fortune right before you go to a dangerous mission? Runs away like a little bitch.
I'll help you. Let's go find her.
Be like, us? Did you not just hear that? The daughter of hatred is down there. Me and a kid fighting with her bare hands and some glass bottles are supposed to take out the daughter of hatred. Showed me the ugly truth of our cosmos, the eternal conflict, angels and demons in battle over control. To what end, I asked, and she simply laughed. Can I, if I do, a laugh emote? Assuming that wasn't what you're supposed to do, but worth a try. They did introduce that mechanic for some reason. Those blood petals that I ate earlier. You have questions, I have answers. I know the fabric of the cosmos. Can't know so little, will you accept my offer? fed to me once. Just a normal thing to drop in conversation. God, why does everybody want this knowledge so bad? Escape the eternal conflict, she tells me. It started with the seduction of the angel. In Arius, all this time, he was just as fallible as any man. Angels apparently want to get after it, too. Oh, shit. Sanctuary's mother. Somehow I felt the truth of it the moment she said it to those knights. Now I know how. She used Inarius to craft this world, a refuge from the eternal conflict. Who created, like, heaven and hell then that started the whole conflict? Let me guess, a dead end. Is she gonna say it? I just wanted to say it again. Sought the origin of humankind. It was always her. From the union of angels and demons came the first generation of humanity. They were powerful, movers of mountains, shakers of seas. Well, that makes sense, where the duality of man comes from then. Running away. Oh, what's down here? This is a little secret. She was proud in the telling of this part. Lilith and Inarius bore a son together. Rathma, he is wise beyond years, the first to untangle the power of necromancy. She said his lair lies deep in Gates of the Cradle. I guess that would be his lair. So bad for this stuff. us down there. Looks like this video is going to be a long one. In our wake. At the cradle. Courts of dawn. More blood to eat. That you're going to meet my son, Rothma, the first necromancer. Is that more? He's the key to my plans. It sounds like they're searching for Lilith's sons, Rothma, together. Well, I have a feeling we're going to be meeting Rothma pretty soon. First I thought the thing said a billfold, a bile fiend. Oh shit. Oh god, I probably shouldn't be standing in that. Things are pretty disgusting looking. Champions no more, I wonder. Do I just have to kill 3 champion mobs in like quick succession or something? Let me guess, this just wraps back around. I don't know if you watch South Park, but I have butters. Lulu, I got some Apple song randomly stuck in my head and I have no idea why. watched any of the episodes where he sings that in years, but just randomly got that stuck in my head. Don't know why I felt the need to share that, but I was kind of just like, not humming it, but click humming that. So that's why I decided to share that. You can tell once I get over an hour into these videos, the quality of commentary starts to nosedive. Undead things go when I kill them, do they just go back to hell? And now till all of them get to sanctuary. Chests or something to make all these alternate paths worth it. What are these? Bring love shirt offerings to the fourth druid spirit to garner favor and receive powerful. Specific quest that I need to do. Shit, did not want to pick that up. And finally, a chest full of garbage. Garbage. And more blood to eat. A god, so what does hellbound mean? Kind of weak, not a very good gift. Receptive. Goddamn. So I have to go down this to the fucking lake, perform a ritual. Goddamn. How long is this gonna take? It's gonna be like a 2 hour long video. Seems like they kind of padded this out more than needed. Oh shit. oppressor. I will not be oppressed. I wonder if you could just run through this. Like, if you actually have to fight all these people, or if you just kept running, if you could outrun them, or if they ever lose aggro. Why do I keep doing like both routes? I just should run through. Clearly, filling everything out has not been rewarded so far. These succubi and stuff just reminded me of the game Dante's Inferno. I only played the demo. I remember there was a free demo on Xbox 360 that I played a lot. I wonder if that game would hold up if you went back. I remember loving the trailer to that game because it had Bill Withers, Ain't No Sunshine When She's Gone, and it was like very fitting. Again, another just random connection made in my brain from this game. The similar theme of going through hell. I think I watched a lot of like the cutscenes to that game, so I know the basis of the story, but never actually really played it. Tried reading the actual Dante's Inferno once, but could not get into it. That's, I don't know, not too abstract, but a little too hardcore of literature for me, or I guess technically I think it's an epic poem. A shivering succubus. Silly, my idle fancies of yesterday seem now. I believed in the Rodrum, but I was misled. With them as our champions, we can barely survive, but Lilith will make us victors. All my life I've been searching, but it was me that needed to be found. Who is writing all this stuff? And is Lilith with Diablo or against him? Because it seems like she's trying to, like, end the conflict between heaven and earth, but I still don't understand what her game plan is, besides, I guess, corrupting humanity, it seems. Would not want to be those guys, or girls. lesson. I'm just gonna go this God damn it, I gotta kill this mirroring succubus, can't let her go. Gonna keep going straight. I have not been rewarded for exploring. Oh, never mind, I guess it's gonna reconnect anyway. I guess I answered part of my question. Looks like these vile stalkers just come up through like lava bits in the ground that randomly spawn, so I guess these demons just spawn in from hell. Oh, how shitty. Okay, this is the black light. Realized I've not been using my evade at all. Oh god. Jesus Christ. Chop that big boy right in half. Shore. Sounds like we're getting closer to the lake. Storming the gates. Nice, we're almost level 18. Who knows, maybe we'll hit level 20 in this video. How sweet this tastes. Lilith asked me to aid in a ritual. Sacrifice a priest from the escort. He has no fight. He just prayed as we made his blood useful. Forgive my hand. I'm still shaking. Power dances along my bones. I walk the path of our maker now. So sounds like her mom's right. I don't know. It's weird. She's with a demon and she's like taking time to write random shit onto rocks for who's she even writing that for. This girl's mom has gone off the deep end. A dead priest. placed a huge gash around his neck, has drained him of his blood. I would say a huge gash of his neck doesn't have a head. That's one way to describe it. A decapitation. Jesus, that'd be hard to find your mom like that. Go ahead, I have your back. Beyond this lake lies the necropolis of the firstborn, a trove of magic and knowledge. So close, I simply need you. Showed me things I can't even put into words. Once I've finished, you will understand. Holy shit, this bitch is off her rocker. God damn. Maybe the last thing she needs is the blood of her daughter. Oh god, do we have to kill her? I guess she's not playing with her bare hands. I guess she has a dagger, maybe. Oh shit. Family shit going on in this game. Bad shitty brothers, husbands that are into kinks of getting their skin cut off, moms being psychos. Sanctuary does not have very good family units, apparently. She might die. God, why won't she give up? How much blood is she using? Oh shit. Oh my god, that thing is big. Should probably actually try to dodge some of these attacks. Pit Lord. Those things are annoying. I had so many fucking health potions. Comes out. God, I hate those fucking things on the floor that make it so you can't see or use your attacks. It's so annoying. Oh god. Fuck. I gotta really pay more attention to where my health is at. Yet. If I knew it was gonna be this long, I would have probably started another video. Can't believe I'm already at an hour and a half. This thing's gonna be like a feature-length film. Red beams are really bad, apparently. Fucking avoid the red shit at all costs. This game definitely punishes melee classes. This would be a lot easier if I could attack at a distance. I'm sorry. I don't want to hate you. I'm trying. I really am. Well, what the fuck did you want me to do? I didn't really have a choice. We're gonna make Lilith pay for what she's done. So we need blessed blood. Go back to Prava. Get that blessing. Beg if you need. Whatever it takes. My mother started this damn ritual. I'm gonna finish it. Meet me in the Mistral Woods. Had a vault there. Finding it was her life's work. So much for that. If not, at least I can bury her where she'd want. So we're not even fighting that guy. God damn it. Pain in my fucking ass. Let's do that. Can I teleport the fuck out of here? Should I go see what's down? Let's just go check really quick. We're already at an hour and a half. Might as well. Oh no, is this just where I came? Okay. Whatever. We're going back to town. But at least we're almost to level 20. God, that really is immersion breaking when it locks up like that. So much transmog stuff for like the one more time I probably play this game before the beta ends. Let's try one more. Yeah, we already have good boots. Let's see if we can get lucky with some gloves. Nope. God damn it. God damn it. Son of a bitch. You motherfucker. That's how they get you. They give you good stuff early on, and then from that point on, you're always chasing that high. Okay, well, I guess we'll end it there. This one is definitely my longest video by far, so really hope if you're trying to sleep, you're not making it to this point. But if you're just watching this to enjoy some whispers and gameplay, I hope you got that. I really appreciate it. spending your time with me. If you made it to this point, thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, please leave a like. If you want to see more, please subscribe. No pressure, though. And I hope I'll see you in the next one. There'll probably be one more in this series. We'll see. Maybe not. Maybe there'll be more. I guess you'll just have to stay tuned. But I hope you have a nice night.